Hi everyone, this is Monica at The Elements, and today I want to show you the principles of alignment taught through Mountain Pose. And perhaps Mountain Pose could be one of the most important postures in yoga because it teaches us alignment. So, with the feet hip-width distance, bring the heels underneath your hip points. This is going to be important because the separation of the feet is going to be depending on the width of your hips. So once you align your feet hip-width distance, lift up all the toes of the mat. So imagine this hand was a foot. You'd be grounding through the big toe mount, the little toe mount, the inside, and then the outside edges of your heels. This creates an imaginary X and allows you to connect to your arches, lifting you a little bit stronger. When your toes relax back down to the mat, bend the knees enough so your shins activate along with your quadriceps. Once you press your feet down and through the mat, the legs will come to straighten. Just be mindful to stay buoyant at your knees, that you're not locking out your knees without any support of your muscle strength. Pelvis comes to a neutral position. So if your pelvis, it is a bowl, but if you tip it forward, the water would spill forward, or if you tip it way back, the water would be spilling back. Think about finding a neutral spine, but that's really up to you to find out what it feels like in your body. Once you find the alignment, draw the belly in and up. Hug your rib cage back and down with the core softly sealed, then lengthen your side lines. As your heart lifts, it puts you in a natural open position, and the palms rotating slightly forward will enhance that feeling. Line of the jaw back is important, guys. We tend to be a lot on our phones with the tilt of the neck. Notice what happens to my cervical spine. Drawing the line of the jaw back is an important thing because it creates that natural curve in the back of your neck. And once you find your mountain pose, eyes closed, and then we breathe. Namaste.